In this video, I will show you how to connect to the Tamulink WPA Enterprise Network. So first you're going to have to connect to your Scuttle. And I'm already connected to my Scuttle, so I'm going to SSH into it. SSH, Debian, there we go. And you're going to put in your password. I'm going to full screen this. Okay. The first program we have is our Tamulink WPA. So we can see I have Tamulink right there. And then you're going to run it. So running it normally with the Python 3, because it is a Python program, we can type in Tamulink WPA. And if we hit enter, it tells you you have to execute a sudo. This is because it's creating some wireless configuration files that require the root user. So we're going to run this as sudo. And then you're going to put in your password. And here you can see it found Tamulink WPA, and here's some configuration stuff that we're going to use to create that, that this program will use to create that file. So, and if you run this program and you don't, and you get an error, so the program will stop working, it will throw an error, all you have to do is run the command conman ctl scan Wi-Fi, and if you hit enter, it'll say scan completed for Wi-Fi. And as long as it says, if you do conman ctl services, as long as you get a list of some wireless networks that are around you, the program should run fine. If this list is empty, that's why you'll get that error. And typically by running conman ctl scan Wi-Fi, you'll fix that error. So we'll get back to our Tamulink WPA. So I'll run that. So here it asks you to enter your username. This is your Texas A&M username without the at tamu.edu. So here I'll put in my username and hit enter. And then our password, or your password. So I've entered my password, and you could say it generated configuration file path. So within this folder, conman, we have our Wi-Fi and then this long name, which comes from here. It's a configuration file for that wireless network. And this program should restart your wireless services for you. But if you type in the command ifconfig, you should see your WLAN 0 get assigned an IP address. You will not be able to see this. Something like this will not show up if your BeagleBone does not connect to the internet. For example, okay, well, all these are connected. But you will not be able to find an IP address if it didn't connect successfully. If your BeagleBone does not connect successfully, you can simply run Tamulink WPA.py again and re-enter your credentials, even if you get it wrong. So now we can see our Tamulink WPA is connected. We can ping google.com. If you get an unresolved, unable to connect to host or anything, you may need to go to sudo nano /etc/resolve.conf, which is configuration, and in here, after you put in your password, we can see here we have a name server. All you need to have in here is name server 8.8.8.8. Not even this line is necessary. As long as your text file looks, or as long as your resolve.configuration at least looks like this, you will be able to contact ping google.com. Once you're able to do that, you have internet. And another way, great way to check is iwconfig, and you can see here that we are, through our WLAN wireless interface, connected to Tamulink WPA. This concludes our video tutorial on connecting to the Tamu WPA Enterprise Network.